first, you have to knead your muscles right now. Knead your muscles. Become aware of your thoughts. Become conscious of your thoughts. Become conscious of what your mind is doing. Become the observer. Become a consciousness, watching your thoughts. Watch what your mind is doing. Observe what your mind is doing. Become aware of the subconscious states of being. Become aware they are not yours. Become conscious of your unconscious thoughts. I want to focus your attention on your breath. Focus your attention on your breath. The rhythm of your heart, your heartbeat. Focus your attention on your heartbeat. Focus your attention on your heartbeat. Focus your attention on your heartbeat. As we go, pay close attention right now. Trying to focus your energy right now. Trying to pull your energy into the future instead of the past. Your body, as your conscious mind, does not know what emotion or thought is creating the experience it is having right now. For some time, some minutes, your mind will go to the future. Your mind will go to the past. Try to be aware of it when it moves. Try to be conscious of it. Bring it back again. Bring it back again on your breath when it goes out. When it goes to the future. When it goes to an event that happened from just today, just yesterday, 5 years ago. Bring it back to your breath. Pull your attention on your breath. You're trying to gain control over that. You're trying to pull your energy into the future right now instead of the past. Become aware of what your mind is doing. Become conscious of your mind. Become aware. It is. When you notice your brain, your mind wandering to the future, your body, as your conscious mind, will begin to respond. This then begins to diminish possibilities in your life. Stay present. Stay conscious. Become aware of your thoughts. Become conscious of your consciousness of being. Breathe in, breathe out. Become aware. Become aware. Why worry? Everything in the universe is responding to what you are asking for. It is constantly given to you. What you are asking of it. Become conscious of the requests, the things you've asked. Become conscious of the answers being given. Become conscious they are moving towards you. Stone has some level of consciousness in it. Money has some level of consciousness in it. It moves. Become aware those things you're asking for are coming. become conscious that they are even conscious of you calling them. Become aware that everything is working really for your good. Become conscious, become aware. The first step to healing your brain is consciousness. Awareness is the only drug that can heal that your depressed brain right now. Consciousness is the only drug that can heal that your depressed brain right now. Become aware of what your mind is doing. Become conscious. Action and reaction are equal and opposite. Action and reaction are equal and opposite. If you find your brain wandering into the future, you're feeling anxiety, you're feeling pain right now, you must have put a thought into your mind. Your body now, as your conscious mind, is beginning to respond to that thought. If you have a thought of fear, the body will respond. It is the unconscious mind. If you have a thought of happiness, joy, your body will begin to respond. It is your conscious mind. Whatever you put in it is what you get. You've taken yourself this far. Your brain is depressed. Your brain is not organized right now. There's no coherence in your brain because you have done this. You are the cause of what has just happened. You are the cause of what is happening right now in your brain. You must learn to take full control of your energy, of your brain. Know what it is used for. Otherwise, you damage, you kill yourself on time. Become aware of yourself. Become aware of who you are. Know who you are. Breathe in, breathe out. Become aware. Let your energy be on your breath. Focus it on your breath. Focus it on your breath. Breathe in, breathe out. Become aware. Let your energy flow around your body right now. Let your energy flow around your body right now. Yeah, pull it to your legs, your toes, your feet. Let it go. Let it go around your body right now. Be appreciative of what is going on in your life. Be happy. Be grateful for your life. Be grateful for that thing you got. Be grateful for the house you bought. Be grateful for that land you bought. Be grateful for this. Be grateful for that. Become happy. Become grateful for everything that you got. Become happy. Your brain is the most powerful weapon you've got. It is powerful. It is powerful. You've got to be aware of that. You've got to be conscious. Are you still thinking, or do you find your mind, your brain, going back to the future? Are you still worried about an event that happened 5 years ago, 7 years ago, 10 years ago in your life? Are you still worried about that? Do you find your energy going back to that event, and your body as your conscious mind beginning to respond to that event? You've got to be aware of that right now. Scientists say 50% of what you say about your past is not even true. Why, you're not the same person. If you can only begin to see that event in another way, then your life will change. Take note, energy is neither created nor destroyed, but can be transformed from one form to another. I say it again, energy can neither be created nor destroyed, but can be transformed from one form to another. Thought energy can be transformed into material things, physical things you see on this planet. It can neither be created nor destroyed, but can be transformed from one thought to another. You cannot destroy the thought that comes into your head. What you can do, you can change it. You can change your energy. Thought is energy. Take note. Thought is a form of energy right now. The most potent form of energy right now on this planet. You've got to be aware that your thought is energy right now. Now you see, if your thought is energy, meaning you've created your life of misery, you've created your depressed life, you've created your life of sorrow, you've created a life of pain, you've created a life of poverty, you've created a life of extreme lack, you've created a life of disgrace, you created everything, you create everything. I always say, number one step to change is not drug. Giving you a drug right now won't help you right now at all. You only need to be conscious. Tremendous amount of consciousness is needed here. Become aware. Become the observer. They are not yours. Those thoughts are not yours. This thought that just come into your mind, sometimes you don't even gain, you don't have control over them. They are not yours. For the first 7 years of your life, you got programs. Your brain was not a level of vibration that was only absorbing any information that was coming in at that time. Your first 7 years of life, your brain just absorbed things people were doing, absorbed how to hit, absorbed what to say, reply to post comments, do this, do that. Your brain absorbed all information without filtering them. Now imagine right now, what if when you're growing up, your brain absorbed words like, you're not good enough, I'm not smart enough, I deserve to die, I deserve to be depressed, I deserve to be sad, I deserve not to be happy. This will reflect in your thoughts. The thoughts you think, the thought that comes to you day to day, day in, day out, they are from the subconscious mind. We only use 5% of our conscious mind every day. 95% coming from the subconscious mind, the programmed mind. The thought majorly comes from your subconscious mind. So if you got bad programs, this will tend to affect how you function in your life. Take note, many people are living other people's lives. Many people are living other people's lives. This is how it will look like. Conscious mind wants to be happy. You want to be happy. You want to break free from that depressed life. You don't want to be depressed again. You want to heal your brain. You don't want to be depressed again. You want to be happy in your life. You want to have a good life. You want to be able to buy a car. You want to be able to own your house. But what is happening right now? The programmed mind is saying, no, no, I have been programmed not to own a house. No, no, I have been programmed you must be depressed. I have been programmed I am not good enough. And since you operate 95% every day from your subconscious mind, then you begin to create all these things. Whenever your conscious mind is aware, your subconscious mind is in action. Whenever you're thinking, your subconscious mind is in action. So this is really telling on you right now. This is the reason, one of the reasons you are depressed right now. It is not your life. So those thoughts that sweep to you every day, become aware they are not yours. They are from the programs. Most of us, you heard phrases like, money is not good, money is bad, it's evil. Those things can affect how you begin to function and think and relate to money. How you begin to function and think and relate to others. You are not interacting with other people because you don't want to interact right now. You're not doing that. You are doing that because majorly you have programmed to do that. You heard phrases when you were small, you heard words, you saw people, probably you grew up in a very bad environment. Now you heard phrases, you said words like, you don't have to interact with people, interaction is not good, or you just saw people not interacting with others. You grew up in a place where there are sad people, people are not friendly, stuff like that. Your brain will not filter, it only absorbs everything is beginning to affect you. So literally you're not living your life, you're living a life from a program, other people's lives. Become aware of that. Awareness is what will heal your brain. Heal your brain by becoming conscious. Heal your brain by becoming aware of what you do, your mind is doing right now. Pull your energy right now into your future. Invest it into your future. The past is gone. That event that happened in your past, let us now look at it. Look at that event in another way. See it in another way. You have the power. You've been given the mental faculty for this. Look at that event that happened 10 years ago that your brain you still pay attention to, and that is making you depressed, it's making you feel fear, making you unhappy right now. Look at that event right now in another form. You have the power to change the energy. Look at it now as a blessing. Look at it now as something that is really good and not the way you see it. Look at it right now. Look at it. You have the power. You have everything it is. Look at it as a blessing. Look at this in another form. In what would it be make you stronger? In what way did it really have good effect on you? Look at it in that way. Look at it, create a new experience right now. Create a new experience right now. You have to take control of your mind right now. See that event in another way. See it in another form. Now you see. You have control over how you look at things. is very important, and as we either make you happy or sad, your ability to control, your ability to know you have the power or to see things the way you want them, the way you really, really want, has been given to you. The more you know that power has been given, and the more you use it, the more you'll become happy, the more you'll become, you will not begin to live that depressed life again. Know that the way you have the power to see the way your friends treat you that makes you sad. You have the power to see it in another way, see it in another form. See it in another way. See it in another form right now. It's energy. You change it, or you can't create or destroy it. You have to change it. You can't wait till the thought is destroyed. No. You got to change how you're seeing it right now. If you can change your energy, you change your life. If you can change your energy, you change your life. Many people are viewing their life. You are viewing your life right now from the lens of your past. And this then begins to diminish possibilities in your life. You are viewing your future from the feelings of the past. You know why? Because you are always overlaying the present moment. With the memories of the past. This then begins to diminish possibilities in your life. Become aware that what is happening right now is as a result of you viewing your future in the lens of the past. It's as a result of you overlaying your present moment with the memories of the past. You're not seeing your future the way it should be. You're seeing your future from the feelings of your past. The feelings of your past is influencing how you're seeing that future. And then you begin to feel anxiety, you begin to feel worry, you begin to feel things are not going to be good, you begin to feel I'm always going to be poor, you begin to feel I'm always going to be depressed for the rest of my life, I should just kill myself, I should just end my life, and this is not going to stop. No energy can be created, not destroyed, but can be transformed from one form to another. If you change your energy right now, you change your life. The power to do that has been given to you. The power to change your life, to transform your life, has been given to you. Use it. It has been given to you. Use the power. Even as you have the right, the power to eat whatever food you want, so also you have the power to sit in whatever way you want, whatever way you need to be helpful to you, whatever way you have the power to see it. The rain and fall, you can see it as a pleasant thing, you can see it as something bad, but you can as well see it as a blessing. You can as well see it as life. You can as well see it as something that supports our existence on this planet. Now, if you look at it in two ways, which one you think will be helpful to you? Which one do you think will give you health, will give you life within? Isn't it the second one? That is how it is. You have the right to see things. There's always an opposite polarity right here around you about things. But cling to the positive side will help you. You have the power technically to do that. You have the power to see it positive. You have the power to see all things that has happened positively. You have the power to see them in the right way. Become aware. Think of that. There's no form, there's no way they've given you, there's no form, there's no right way to see things. You can see it either good, you can see it bad. So become aware of the form, become aware of your energy right now. You are about to pull that energy into your future. Now begin right now. You first of all want to break your old habits. You first of all want to break that chain. The chains are holding you back to the past. It's awareness. Awareness is a drug right now. Not any drug will give to you. Awareness can heal your brain. Awareness can heal your brain right now. Become aware. Become conscious. From personal experience, I too was depressed. I was so sad the rest of my life. Depression was like a brother to me. I'm always depressed. When someone says to me, "You're not good enough," I stay there, stay in that emotion for days, a couple of days, even a couple of weeks. It's so bad, it's so unpleasant, it's so bad. I passed through this thing for a very long time right now, and I reap the consequences right now of putting a bad thought in your head, of putting a good thought in your head. Take note of that. When my life began to change, it was the moment I realized that I had the power to see things in different ways. There are multiple options, there are multiple ways you can see a particular event that happens in your life, and I began to choose the best way or the best option for me that would be good for me, for my mental health, my productivity. And then, man, my life changed, my life was transformed. You can do the same. See that event and choose the option right now that is best for you. You have the power to do that. You have the power to choose. It has been given to you. You have the power to choose. Now take note. Mental picture is a concentrated form of energy right now. So you are about to pull your energy right now, concentrate your energy right now. Form a mental picture of who you want to be. Form a mental picture of who you want to be. You can start by forming a mental picture of who you don't want to be. Or you just go the other way around, who you want to be. Form a mental picture of who you don't want to be. Right now, form a mental picture of who you want to be. Right now, as you go through the process, become conscious. From a mental picture of your life, man. From a mental picture of you traveling the world, if that is what you want. From a mental picture of you having fun with your wife, your children, your family. From a mental picture of you owning your car, buying your house. From a mental picture of you traveling the world where you really want to. From a mental picture right now. You have you want to become a deliberate creator of your life. You want to create your life. You want to create from a state of consciousness. You want to create your whole life. You want to be take full responsibility of what will happen in your life right now. You have been given the power. You have been given the mental faculties required for anything you want in your life right now. So form a mental picture. Form a mental picture. Pull your energy to the future. You've always pulled your energy to the past. What did you get? What was the result? Anxiety, depression, worry, fear, lack, poverty, extreme lack. Unproductivity. That was a result. That was the consequences of pulling your energy to the past. So pull your energy to the future right now. It's not a waste of time. You've always pulled your energy to the past. What did you get? Depression, lack, worry. So now pull your energy to the future. How do you want to see your life? How do you want to navigate? How do you want to see things that will happen to you today? How do you want to see the world? See the world. How do you want to see the world? You want to see it as a lost thing, as a decaying thing? See the world as a perfect thing right now, as something perfect going into completion right now. You gotta see it as something perfect right now. That is a cure to your brain. Heal your brain right now. You see, you have the power to heal your brain. You are the from the picture right now. Who you want to be? How many cars do you want to buy? How many houses do you want to build right now? Begin to form a mega picture of how you want to see your life, how you want to do things, how you want to act, how you want to respond to people. Know that those old ways of responding to people, those old ways of doing things are not yours. They are other people's ways of doing things, not your way. So you have to create your way. See your own way of doing things right now. I'll leave you right now as you form the picture of who you want to be. Create your life right now. Create your life. Hold this mental picture right now. And transform your world right now. And I'll leave you with this, lastly. Know that you have the power to see things in ways that will help you become successful. There are multiple ways of seeing just one event. There's no particular way you should see an event. See it in a way that will help you. You've probably seen it in ways that did not help you, and you got depressed, you got fear, you got anger. So see it now in a way that is energy change, because that's transformation of energy right now. See it in a way that will be helpful to you. Know that you have that power to see it in ways that will be helpful to you. For every event that happened in my life, I always see it in a way that is helpful to me. I always choose the option that I know will help me to become successful. That is it. To go through, make sure you see that event as a blessing rather than as a curse. You have the power to create your life.